Previously on Dirty Sexy Money.
Your campaign of terror, murder, mayhem will not be tolerated any longer.
Joe Biden is a rabid dog. He should be beaten to death with a stick.
I think you called me a liar on national TV.
I don't
want
to get mad. I just want to say hi, Bernie.
Yeah, good. Okay.
I'm confronting him, though. I'm not getting talked about anymore. So we're going to play this game where you're going to try to blow my game up here. Let me say your truth. Let's go. You want to tango? Let's tango. Chrissy trying to blow up my game. She's going to get ready for war in a second.
You work for a company that was fixing bread prices.
Came, he saw, he died.
We must stop the terror. I call upon all nations to do everything they can to stop these terrorist killers.
Thank you.
Now watch this drive.
City in the world outside of Italy, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
What are you thinking about when that buzzer sounds for that one? What are you thinking about when the 15th round when you're coming out?
You're listening to the Society Show.
You know, we're living in a society.
On today's episode, Jeff Bezos and Bill Gates have an oligarch fight over a Pentagon cloud contract.
Fielding Wellingtonsworth?
Hello.
Livingston Winsterford?
Yes.
The CIA used global encryption to spy on other countries.
You work for a company that was fixing bread prices.
A man who was shot by plainclothes ICE officers sues them.
What the hell is wrong with me?
The US tries to bully Europe into rejecting Huawei and it isn't working.
I don't want to do any of that.
Duh. Which is why I was joking about doing it.
Just the EU wants Greece's Elgin marbles back from the UK as part of the Brexit deal.
What do you want, Breton trash?
Tesla's Berlin gigafactory is put on hold due to mass deforestation.
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
A far-right mass shooter in Germany kills 9.
Fucking asshole.
The Albanian president calls for people to overthrow the government.
Democrats decided to shield and shelter criminals. Look, wait. You have criminals.
The U.S. sanctions a Russian oil company for helping Venezuela.
Venezuela is the kind of place you should go to war with because they have lots of oil and we'll take that.
Bolivia's Supreme Electoral Tribunal will not allow the rightful president Evo Morales to run for Senate.
You think that shit's
voted Monday to keep it legal?
Who would do that? Who would do that?
Former Australian Prime Minister Tony Abbott claims that the Malaysian government believes and always believed that Malaysia Flight 370 crashed due to the pilot committing murder-suicide. All of that and much more on The Society Show. Jeff Bezos became upset,
makes me mad,
that Microsoft,
Bill Gates up there with that little chicken neck, you know how he walked like a demonic elf, hey Bill Gates,
got a $10 billion,
and we hold the world ransom for $1 million
cloud contract. And so he's tying up the court.
Man lit a joint inside a Wilson County courtroom.
With an oligarchic melodrama.
Fielding Wellingtonsworth?
Hello.
Livingston Winsterford?
Yes.
Amelia Bedford Furthington Chesterhill?
Good day.
And James William Bottomtooth?
Oh, no.
A federal judge ordered a...
Stop! You violated the law.
Temporary block on the so-called Jedi...
Hello there.
...cloud contract. Jedi standing for Joint...
Man lit a joint...
...Enterprise Defense Infrastructure.
Okie dokie.
After Amazon...
Jeff Bozo...
...filed the suit.
Headshot.
The Jedi contract was awarded to Microsoft...
Hey, Bill
Gates.
For up to $10 billion.
We hold the world ransom for $100 billion.
To update the Pentagon's IT operations.
Jeff Bozo
is protesting,
running riot,
the deal.
This is the deal.
Because he claims it was awarded to Microsoft because of a personal grudge.
You suck! You're no talent, a piece of shit!
Between Trump and
I'm sitting there tweeting, bing, bing, bing.
Jeff Bozo.
Due to Bezos owning the Washington Post.
You are fake news.
We're not so different, you and I. When I was insolent, I was placed in a burlap bag and beaten with reeds. Pretty standard, really.
The CIA.
I am William F. Buckley of the Central Intelligence Agency.
Use global encryption to spy on other countries.
So what's the deal with politics? I don't get it.
Over 100 countries.
100.
Use encryption equipment. From a Swiss company called Crypto AG for secret communication. You thought you could keep this shit from me, yeah. Come to find out, Crypto AG was owned by the CIA and the BND.
Oh, good for you!
West Germany's intelligence agency in what was called Operation Rubicon. But I do admit I'm sad. The Five Eyes Alliance, which includes the US as well as the UK, Australia,
maybe the dingo ate your baby,
Canada,
my mood isn't perfectly regulated,
and New Zealand, also likely had access to this intelligence. The U.S. is trying to bully Europe.
Great American food.
Into rejecting Huawei and it isn't working.
Nope, not gonna work.
Tension within NATO has.
These would-be gods of the New World Order.
Been increasing due to the fight between U.S.
That's okay, we're just gonna tariff your nation. We're gonna tariff you. Either you're gonna agree or not.
In Europe. Regarding Huawei and the implementation of 5G technology. Both Secretary of State Mike Pompeo and
you are everything that's gone wrong in this world.
House Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
Democrats have done nothing.
Warned European NATO countries.
Stop.
About using Huawei. At the Munich Security Conference. Threatening their relationship with the U.S.
Are you threatening me? My bunghole will ask the questions.
The U.S.'s anti-Huawei campaign has largely failed.
If you want your candidate to win, you gotta shape up.
Britain ignored Trump's warning to cut off intelligence ties with the UK.
We are sexy bitches, yeah!
It seems likely that Germany and Italy will implement Huawei technology. You my future wifey. Poland has agreed not to implement Huawei.
Right. Polish sassy.
Okay? I mean, it's a family thing, I think.
So,
my brother's in it.
Sausage.
Australia has also agreed not to implement Huawei.
Knife. That's a knife.
Soldier boy, tell me.
The EU wants Greek's Elgin marbles back from the UK as part of the Brexit deal.
What do you want, Breton trash?
Greece demanded a clause be inserted in the Brexit deal.
Just do it!
For the UK to return the national artifact that they stole from Greece.
Whoa, isn't that stealing?
No, it's just looting.
The UK argues that the Elgin marbles were taken lawfully. However, this is a misrepresentation.
Calm down!
down. It's okay.
Earl of Elgin originally intended to make replicas.
1 hour later.
Greece was controlled by the Ottoman Empire at that point.
What you say?
There's also conflicts about fishing. The UK wants to take full control of UK's fishing waters. But the EU wants European boats to continue to have access to fish. A German court ordered Tesla to stop.
Stop! You violated the law.
The construction of what people are calling a quote gigafactory in the forested outskirts of Berlin. The Higher Administrative Court of Berlin-Brandenburg,
man lit a joint inside a Wilson County courtroom,
ruled that Tesla needs to at least consider the appeal from an environmental group called Greenling Brandenburg.
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
In order to continue deforesting land for the factory.
Work, 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 work. It's a me heavy work, 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 work.
The Green League filed an emergency appeal immediately after deforestation began, as Tesla began cutting down trees on their nearly 225-acre property.
Cut my life into pieces, this is my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing.
The Albanian president has called for people to overthrow.
When the revolution comes, you can bloody well be sure that your head's going to be first on the chopping block.
The Albanian government, after parliament launched impeachment proceeding against him.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
Albania's centrist president, Ilir Meta.
What would it be?
Accused the left-wing parliament of violating the country's constitution.
Stop! You violated the law.
He also said they have links to organized crime.
I don't hear an alarm. Let's take stuff.
A big part of the conflict is rooted in reforms that parliament has pushed.
Yada, yada, yada.
That would allow Albania to be prepared to join the EU.
So what's the deal with politics? I don't get it.
Parliament started impeachment proceedings against President Ilir Meta because he tried to cancel municipal elections last year.
Okie dokie.
After the center-right opposition party boycotted the election and accused the government of vote rigging.
I'm a bitch, I'm a lover, I'm a child, I'm a mother, I'm a sinner, I'm a saint, I do not feel ashamed.
The U.S. Treasury has blacklisted Rosneft Trading S.A.
That's okay, we're just going to tariff your nation. We're going to tariff you. Either you're going to agree or not.
The Geneva-based trading unit of the Russian subsidiary oil firm Rosneft.
I've been asked to talk about Russia, and I might talk about Russia.
Russia threatened that this would cause deterioration between the two countries, and it wouldn't deter Russia from trading with Venezuela. Venezuela criticized it as an attack on Venezuelan people.
Venezuela is the kind of place you should go to war with because they have lots of oil and we'll take that.
Rosneft says the sanctions are a quote outrage and that the U.S. Treasury Department has not given any formal reason for the sanctions.
I just want you to know.
Bolivia's Supreme Electoral Tribunal is not allowing the rightful president Evo Morales to run for Senate.
You're telling me it isn't real when they had a fucking vote in the goddamn fucking Senate!
Bolivia's court declared that Evo Morales cannot run for Senate.
Yes, indeed, boo. Yes, indeed, hiss.
Because he doesn't meet the residency qualifications.
Locals only! Locals only!
However, Morales didn't move to another country. He was forced into exile after the right-wing coup threatened his life.
Are you threatening me? My bunghole will ask the questions.
There is a good thing, though, because the Bolivian election will be in May.
And then we're going to Washington, D.C. to take back the White House! Yeah!
And Morales' former economic minister, Luis Arce, I think I'm saying that right, is the current frontrunner for president.
He'll contest it.
This is largely due to the ineptitude of the Bolivian right,
conclave of conservatives,
who is in a power struggle with itself.
Because I'm you. No, I'm me. I'm me, he says.
Running multiple candidates that are all competing with each other for a smaller and smaller audience.
I just want you to know I found a reason for me to change who I used to be.
This is 2020.
This is 2020.
This is 2020.
State of the state. State of the state.
In pre-capitalist economies, people understood the state differently than we do now. If you were a feudal peasant, then lords and vassals and upper classes like that were the political ruling classes. But they also had a much more directly beneficial relation to the means of production than the current day politicians, most of the time. And they also obviously had a much more beneficial relation to the means of production than the feudal peasants. The peasants lived on the lands of the lords and vassals. They were forced to surrender aid to the lords and vassals. They were forced to join the militaries of the lords or work the lands of the vassals. For them, the people exerting political and economic control were the same. You didn't have a boss and a politician and a police that were separate. They weren't even considered separate things that overlapped. They both gained their economic and political power because they were the same thing. To go further back, if you lived in an ancient slave society like the Roman Empire, your slave owners would obviously be inextricably tied to the state if we take the state to mean the thing that's ruling over you politically. The same people who were forcing slaves to work had both political and economic power. There has never been a governing system that did not directly control who performs labor and who benefits the most from that labor and how they benefit from that labor. In this sense, all governments are dictated by a class. The laws of a capitalist country are designed by capitalists and people who enable capitalism. And yet, when we talk about capitalism, we talk about the labor force and the labor market, things like that, as things that are completely divorced from the state apparatus. Even when people have some government jobs or something like that, we don't even think of that as part of the state. We conceive capitalist economies as being comprised of autonomous, separate little companies that could exist independent of the state and other companies. But then you hear stories like Amazon and Microsoft fighting over 10 billion contracts from the state. And you also hear about Clearview AI. I don't know if you have heard about this.
Hey, well, do you hear about this?
But it's a facial recognition company that has contracts with local police to help catch people. So when private companies are accumulating profit and working in sync with each other to do things that a state would conventionally do, the state power doesn't dissipate and go away. The state power is transferred to a private capitalist enterprise. Companies like Amazon and Microsoft and Clearview aren't unique. All capitalist companies depend on the state, and the state depends on them. For example, the U.S. state could distribute food to everyone as a government program. Instead, they offload the duty of food distribution to private companies. The state depends on the food industry to ensure people get food. The company depends on the state, which enables their ability to accumulate capital. Tech companies like Amazon and Microsoft, and even more dubious companies like Clearview, offer a transparently bleak vision of what privately held state power looks like. It would help all of us analyze society and the
You know, we're living in a society!
State more accurately by having a broad understanding of what constitute the state. The capitalist workplace and private capitalist sector is indeed an apparatus of a capitalist state. Let's say a coronavirus like the one in China broke out in the U.S. on the same scale. Privately owned capitalist corporations wouldn't have the incentive or organizational ability to handle the outbreak as well or as quickly as the state-run medical sector of China. For example, if you return from a vacation in China to the U.S. and you do not have insurance, you will be much less likely to go to the hospital. In most countries, they don't have that issue. In the countries that do have that issue, it's usually because of lack of access to medical care, not because it's exorbitantly expensive. The U.S. is not prepared for a lot of things like the coronavirus or natural disasters. And a lot of that is caused by capitalist companies not having the incentive to take care of those problems. Isn't that an issue of the state? That the state offloads the state duty to a capitalist company that actually has no incentive of doing that state duty.
State of the state.
And that's the state of the state.
State of the state.
Till next time, take care of yourself and each other.
Next time on Dragon Ball Z.
Every time you create something new, there should be questions. And to me, that's a sign that you've actually done something.
That's okay, we're just gonna tariff your nation. We're gonna tariff you. Either you're gonna agree or not.
Diamond earring came off in the ocean and it's gone. Okay, but there's people that are dying.
When the revolution comes, you can bloody well be sure that your head's gonna be first on the chopping block.